Bless. Yeah?
Okay. Ok, on est toujours en direct du Garance Reggae Festival à Bagnols-sur-Cèze, émission 2011. On est toujours en backstage avec pas mal d'artistes qui passent, qui repassent à côté des loges. On en a attrapé trois parce qu'il fallait absolument faire un point sur la tournée et sur l'hommage rendu ce soir à Coxon à travers la grosse affiche Studio One. Et à côté de moi, j'ai trois légendes, on va dire, nouvelles comme anciennes légendes et des légendes vraies et toujours debout. Du label Studio One, Mr. Amageddon, Willie Williams, la nouvelle génération, Mr. Alpheus, et le très célèbre Winston Francis, un des plus grands chanteurs du Studio One. Welcome to us.
Thank you so much.
It's a great pleasure to receive you tonight at Party Time.
Give thanks.
For this festival.
Yeah, man.
Greetings. First time for you. Not the first time for Alpheus. It's like a family. So the purpose of the interview is about Studio One.
Sure.
Yes.
First question: How did you get your first recording in Studio One?
Your first recording. Well, I was introduced to Studio One by a very good friend of mine called Jackie Estick. He used to write for on the back of all the albums, and I was going to school in the States then. And when I came home, I wanted to get involved. And he told me the best person you can actually deal with is Clement Coxon Dodd. And he was right. He was absolutely right, because he was the best in the business. He was one of the innovators, you know, and he had a lot of vision. I was just saying to Ken Booth a while ago, wouldn't Mr. Dodd be proud today to come to a festival like this and see thousands of French people, you know, not speaking English and enjoying his music that he envisaged so long ago.
For years.
But like Ken said, he's not here to really enjoy that, but King Stitch is here to enjoy it. So, you know, we are just, you know, is followers, really, you know, because he's the one who actually gave us, you know, this great, great opportunity. That's where we are here today, 50 True. Years later.
True.
Not too late. And Willie, for you, your first recording with Studio One, talk about.
With my first recording with
your
Studio
first meet.
One was 1968, right? Well, I was just about leaving school and met
was
up
young.
With... Yes, very young, you know, meet up with brother called Mr. Keith Anderson, known as Baba Andy, right? Yes, and I was introduced to Studio One through him, and the rest is history.
And for you, Alpheus, some years later?
Yeah, my introduction was, I was in Florida. I was going through some really hard times, and my friend invited me there, and he knew I used to DJ when I was a child. So he said, go to the studio, called Dub Lab Studio, with Sata Blue, and just do some jingles for his sound. And I was singing just to test the mic, and Tony Brevet was there from the Melodians, and he said, hey, you know, you sound good, I'm going to take you to Coxon Dodd. I said, okay. And then that's it. I met him on the J train somewhere in New York, and then he took me to Studio One, and that's it, man.
What image you have nowadays?
What did he make me keep? What did who make me keep?
If you have one word to describe Coxon.
Yes.
Which word?
King. He wise.
Wise.
Very wise man. Wisdom. That's the one word I get from him.
And you always
I'll say he's the king. You know,
the king.
Number one.
Producer.
And maybe that's why you call his studio one. First.
One.
Yes,
two.
Yes.
And you?
What I can say about Coxon, what I know about, is that was a genius.
Genius, the first.
You know, yeah.
For you, is there a new Coxon nowadays?
Well, I haven't seen another one.
There's always Coxon dads in the world, you know. It's just genetically, or, you know, people see things. But you still have lots of people with good intention and, you know, to make not just music, but something else too, you know.
No, Coxon is gone.
May I say something to you? I was recording one night in the studio, and when we came to playback, because Coxon sometimes, he would not be in the studio when we were recording. It was Sylvan Morris, the engineer. And Mr. Dodd would come in the evening and listen to what was done. And when we were listening to the tape, I said to him, "Sir D, I can't hear the music. Would you turn it up some more?" And he said to me, "Winston, you don't listen with your ears, listen with your heart." You know, and that is the reason why, you know, I think.
I want to know, are you still working with Studio One? Have you some have you still some links with the family, with his daughter?
No, I'm not actually seen Carol for a long time, but his son Junior Dad, believe me, you ask if there is another Mr. Dad, there is Junior Dad, because he looks just like his father. He stands up just like his father, puts his foot against the wall, just like his dad. And the resemblance, when I went to Cox's funeral and I saw Junior, I had to look twice because I thought they said he was dead. But he looked just like his father. And he talks quiet. Mr. Dad never raised his voice, not even in anger.
Yep.
You know, he was always quiet, you know. And he'd say, if everybody's getting mad, he said, "Jackson, listen, just take it easy. Yeah. You know, be cool." You know, and Junior is the same way like his father. You know, so there is another Coxon Dad.
Have you some links, Alpheus?
Yeah, I think there is. I think his name is Roberto Sanchez. And not just because I just done a new album with him, but I just think this man is a genius.
Yeah.
I just think he's a genius, and I think if Mr. Dodd was still alive, I would bring him there, and Mr. Dodd would be shocked with what this man can do with creating rhythm track. It's unbelievable. So yeah, I think it's him.
And you, Willie, have you some links? Still some links with the Coxon family?
Well, from time to time, I used to drop by the studio in Jamaica. You know, whether or not whichever family member is there, even before the passing of his wife and himself, you know, regardless. But I think the message is greater than the messenger. So you can't equate both of them, you know, because what he brought was a lot of jobs to people all around the world, like even tonight, you know. Away from Jamaica, you know, people working because of that cause, you know.
We're speaking the same language.
Yeah.
In different contexts. You know, music, Studio One.
But stop with the past, actually. What are you working for?
Well, at the moment.
Project?
Well, see, one thing about us, when I say us, I'm speaking for Willie, Alpheus, and all the other artists that were here. We never stop working. You know, we're constantly recording. We're doing live shows. Because, you see, like Willie said, we are messengers, you know, of the truth. And musically, music has united the world. Because if you go back to biblical times, when Saul, King Saul, he was mad at times, and he would say, "Kill a whole village of people." The only thing that could bring him back to reality is King David would go and play his harp, and he would strum some reggae music, and it would calm King Saul right down. So music is the key, you know, and we are singers and players of instruments. So you find that we have a job to do of spreading love throughout the world.
True. We can hope to have a new album of Winston Francis.
Yes, yes, yes. Soon? I have got 3 new albums coming out at the same time.
Wow. Great. Willie? What about your actuality?
Pardon me?
Your actuality?
You have a new album.
Have you a new album?
Yes, I have. I always have projects, you know, going on, whether it's an album or a single. Because, you know, I work from I try to introduce reggae to all genres of music. You know, sometimes I work with some rap people who do rap music. Mm-hmm. You know, we have a project that was done with a band in the United States called Government Mule. Yeah. You know, okay. And we have tracks that we do with various other artists. You
maybe
know.
For this year?
We have an album that's supposed to be released before the end of this year.
So check it out.
We're looking forward to that. Yeah, bless.
And for Alpheus, the masterpiece. The masterpiece in store.
well, at the moment it's From Creation album, which is new.
The big album.
Yeah, hopefully, I hope everybody can feel the vibes. And that's what I'm focused on, is that album and trying to do as many shows to convey it to the world. And also in the future to do another album, the same, you know. So, yeah, it is. We're still working on the right vein of project.
Let me say this: I've got an album that I did with a friend of mine. He was from the group, the Chosen Few. Called Stand Firm. It was released in 2007, but it was not released properly. So. We have gone back, remixed the album, and it's coming out again. So that I'm really looking forward to, because it's a brilliant album. And I've also got one called Special Someone, which is another brilliant album. So I'll let you hear it later on.
The last question. It's really a big pleasure for you to be together to tribute to Coxon.
Well,
it's a real pleasure to...
Yeah, man.
To sing together on the same stage.
Well, from day one, it was always a pleasure to go to Studio One, you know, because you see what the returns it bring, you know. So,
yeah, man.
You know, it still is a pleasure, you know, musically, you know. Yeah, man.
It's still a family.
Still a family.
A school, absolutely. A family.
You know something?
Not a school, an academy.
When you meet someone that did record at Studio One, it's strange. Because there is an immediate link. There's an immediate, because Mr. Dodd, I think, chose his artist.
Yeah.
He would read people. You have to go there every day for a long time before he can feel you. And I think he tries to choose the same kind of person in all of us. And, you know, like, it's a great thing. And when we sing, we all sing at the same time, it's going to be good.
If you have a last word to say to the people,
sing it.
You have a punchline.
Keep the faith. Every day won't be the same, no. That's a guarantee, take it from me, yeah.
If you have a last word in song.
Well, if I had to sing a last song, I don't hear the question.
If you have some words to say to the French audience.
Okay, yes, I have words of positiveness, you know, that I'm glad to be here representing what it is and be a part of the family, the living family, you know, as we are trying to put some joy in the people's heart, you know.
So the next time you're in Paris, you're welcome in party time in the studio.
We have to.
To do an interview, especially from.
We have to.
Willie Williams.
Yeah, man.
No problem. Thanks to be here. Winston, if you have a last word.
My last word is very special, because I have got a confession to make. My granduncle name was Nathaniel Chavans, and he was from Marseille?
Yeah. Just
my great granduncle.
Yeah.
Was from Marseille.
You're like a
so
French.
So I am home. I am
you're
home.
French. Winston Francis. Francis is French name.
But my granduncle, he was from Marseille, and his name was Nathaniel Chavans.
Okay.
And his sister married my grandfather, who was a McCoy. Right. So for me, I am home. You know, I came back home. You know, so I'm very, very proud, you know, of my friend connection. Yes, man, bless.
Welcome home. to close the thing, if you have some one punchline for the people.
Well, I would just like to say I thank the French people for everything that they've done for me, because in 1996 I had a record that was released in France, Stand By Me, and it sold over 300,000. So thank you, France. You bought me some new cars and you bought me a nice house. Thank you very much. God bless.
Voilà, c'était les trois légendes, Mr. Willie Williams himself, Alpheus et Winston Francis. Réunis, on espère encore d'autres artistes. Il y a Mr. Gussipé aussi dans la place. Il y a plein d'artistes. On vous tient au courant. Merci, c'était un tribute to Studio One. Un dernier mot.
Bless up.
I gotta say, big up party time.
Yeah,
because I tell you something right now.
Party time every
you guys
time.
Yeah. Big up party Soul time. Stereo, big them up. Big up Garance for making it happen, for making sure everything is happening.
Yes, man.
Big up United, Reggae, Reggaeville, Africa, One, everybody for
thanks,
keeping
man.
The faith.
Bless up. Bless
really,
up.
Really.
Yeah, man. Big.
Bless.
Thanks to be. Voilà, on va les laisser tranquilles. Après, il y a encore la deuxième partie du show de Studio One, encore avec Jim Brown, Lone Ranger. Il y a King Steed aussi qui est là. On va essayer Carlton Livingston, merci Tarzan. Dillinger, Prince Jasbo, voilà, que la crème des crèmes, les légendes même du reggae music qui sont là ce soir en direct dans Party Time. Je vous laisse avec le reste du concert, la diffusion du concert de Burning Spear. On se retrouve tout à l'heure sur Party Time, www.partytime.fr. On est en direct.
But
come on, yeah.